So in the previous videos, I posted some scenarios for analytical function and the approach using which we can solve them easily. Let's write the queries for those scenarios in this video. It will become really easy if you have watched the previous videos as well. I will be pasting the entire DDL and DML in the pinned comment so that you can practice these questions on your own. For the first one, we had to display the contribution percentage of the product to the total sales. So first we have to calculate total sales and we should show the total sales for all rows. Since we are not partitioning or windowing our total sales, it should be same for all rows. For that, we will write select star from product window demo table. P will be the alias for this table. And now we will write the syntax of our analytical function. We know that the analytic function over keyword and the over clause is mandatory and the rest is optional. Now sum is the analytic function and we want to calculate the sum of sales. So that will be our argument. Do we want to partition our data? No. We want to show sales for all rows. So we do not need the window boundary either. Let's run this and we get the total sum in front of every row. Now we just need to divide our sales with this and multiply the result with 100 and we will get our contribution percentage. Let's round it off to make it more clean and we will get the contribution percentage, which is the answer we were looking for. For the next one, we have to calculate the cumulative sum on the basis of our date column. Here, if we look closely, we do not have to partition our data. We just have to calculate the cumulative sum. Let's write our analytic function. We want to do the sum of sales, then our over keyword. For over clause, we do not want to partition our data. And for cumulative sum, we want to add current row with all rows that come before it. So we will write order by sales date and we will write rows between unbounded preceding and current row. Unbounded preceding because we want to consider all rows that come before our current row. By default, order by sorts our data in ascending order, and as we discussed earlier, even if we go ahead and remove the windowing clause from this query, it will give the exact same output. Let's verify that. We will copy this and we will remove the explicit window clause and it gives the exact same result. So order by column name in background works exactly as rows between unbounded preceding and current row. For the next one, we have to calculate the cumulative sum again, but this time we want it to be on the basis of our products. So our order by clause remains the same. We can choose to add rows between unbounded preceding and current row, or we can also leave it. Now we just have to add the partition by clause on the basis of product and we get what we were looking for. For the next one, we have to calculate the average cases for the day. As the statement suggests, we have to take the average of cases. Let's write our over keyword and now we want the cases to be showed for the day in front of every row. So we will have to partition our data by date. Do we need a windowing clause? No. We just want to show each day cases. Let's round it off to make it look a little more clean and we get the answer. For the next one, we have to calculate the average cases of last 7 days in that city. Now this is an interesting one, something which is not possible without an explicit boundary or window specification. Let's write our mandatory syntax. Since we want the average of cases, that will be our analytic function argument. Now, do we want to partition our dataset? Yes, we want the average to be calculated only for that city. Do we need a window specification? Yes, we want to take average cases for the last 7 days. And when we have to explicitly specify our window, order by and rows between become mandatory. We have to order our data by cases date and we want to go back 7 days. So we will use n preceding for that. So we will write rows between 7 preceding, and since we do not want to include the current row, we will write one preceding and bam, we get the answer we were looking for. If you understand the problem statement and the syntax, the rest becomes really easy. The next one is another interesting scenario where we have to normalize salary of employees on the basis of their experience, and we have to compare them with the employees having the same designation in their own departments. We have to calculate the average salary of employees closest to them in terms of experience, 3 before and 3 after, and if their salary is less than the average, then we have to display normalization required, else we can display at par or above. We know we need to take the average, so average salary will be our analytic function. Then comes the over keyword, and for our over clause, we first have to partition the dataset on the basis of departments and designation. Now we need to select 3 before and 3 after on the basis of experience. So we need a window here. We will order the dataset by experience in months. Rows between will be our standard keyword, and we will specify 3 preceding and 3 following. This gives us the average salary of employees in the same department on the same designation, closest in terms of experience to the employee. Now, if employee salary is less than the average, we can specify needs normalization, else at par or above, and our case statement will come really handy in doing so. So this is the query with the case statement that will give what we were looking for. In case if you are not comfortable with case, please let me know. I will make a separate video on it. The remaining two questions are very straightforward as well. Now that we are well versed with the syntax. For the next one, we have to calculate the sum of sales for the next 3 days, excluding the current date. So we will write our function again. Sum will be our analytic function. So we want to capture sum of sales. Then we will specify the keyword over. Now we do not want to partition our data, but we want to create a window for next 3 days. So we wrote order by, sales date, rows between, 1 following and 3 following, and we get what we were looking for. Now we can easily compare how accurately we were predicting the next 3 days sales when we compare our projected against actual sales. For the final one, we have to show max sales that we have done with the client after the current month or the current date. Here we want to take the max of sales and we want to partition our data on the basis of client. Let's do that. Also, we have to order our dataset on the basis of date. We do not want to include the current row, so we will specify rows between, 1 following, and we want to consider everything till the very end. So we will have to specify unbounded following, and we will get the final answer as well. If you found it difficult to understand or solve these queries on your own, you may want to revisit the earlier videos of this section and you will get a better hang of it. And if you still have any doubts, please let me know. I'll be happy to help.